And the Lord said unto Moses, Hew thee two tables of stone, like unto the first, and I will write upon these tables the words that were in the first tables, which thou breakest. And be ready in the morning, and come up in the morning unto Mount Sinai, and present thyself there to me in the top of the mount. And no man shall come up with thee, neither let any beast be seen throughout all the mount, neither let the flock nor herds feed before that mount. And he hewed two tables of stone like unto the first. And Moses rose up early in the morning, and went up into Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, and took in his hand the two tables of stone. And the Lord descended in a cloud, and stood with him there, and proclaimed the name of the Lord. And the Lord passed by before him, and proclaimed, the Lord God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering, and abundant in goodness and truth, keeping mercy for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, and that will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, and upon the children's children, unto the third and to the fourth generation. And Moses made haste, and bowed his head toward the earth, and worshipped. And he said, If now I will have found grace in thy sight, O Lord, let my Lord, I pray thee, go among us, for it is a stiff-necked people, and pardon our iniquity and our sin, and let us for thine inheritance, and take us for thine inheritance. And he said, Behold, I make a covenant before all thy people, I will do marvels, such as have not been done in all the earth, nor in any nation, nor all the people, and all the people among which thou art shall see the work of the Lord, for it is a terrible thing that I will do with thee. Observe that thou that which I commanded thee this day. Behold, I drive out before thee the Amorite, and the Canaanite, and the Hittite, and the Perizzite, and the Hevite, and the Jebusite. Take heed to thyself, lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land whither thou goest, lest it be for a snare in the midst of thee. But ye shall destroy their altars, break their images, and cut down their groves. For thou shalt not worship no other god. For the Lord, whose name is Jealous, is a jealous God. Lest thou make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land, and they go a whoring after their gods, and do sacrifice unto their gods, and one call thee, and thou eat of his sacrifice. And thou take of their daughters unto thy sons, and their daughters go a whoring after their gods, and make thy sons to go whoring after their gods. Thou shalt make thee no molten gods. The feast of unleavened bread shalt thou keep 7 days. Thou shalt eat unleavened bread, as I have commanded thee in the time of the month Abib. For the month Abib thou camest out of Egypt. All that openeth the matrix is mine, and every firstling among thy cattle, whether ox or sheep, that is male. But the firstling of an ass thou shalt redeem with a lamb, and if thou redeem him not, then shalt thou break his neck. All the firstborn of thy sons thou shalt redeem, and none shall appear before me empty. 6 days shalt thou work, but on the seventh day thou shalt rest. In earing time and in harvest thou shalt rest. And thou shalt observe the feast of weeks, of the first fruits of wheat harvest, and the feast of the ingathering at the year's end. Thrice in the year shall all your men appear before the Lord God, the God of Israel. And I will cast out the nations before thee, and enlarge thy borders. Neither shall any man desire thy land, when thou shalt go up to appear before the Lord thy God thrice in the year. Thou shalt not offer the blood of my sacrifice with leaven, neither shall the sacrifice of the feast of the Passover be left unto the morning. The first of the first fruits of thy land thou shalt bring unto the house of the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not seethe a kid in his mother's milk. And the Lord said unto Moses, Write thou these words, for after the tenor of these words I have made a covenant, and with thee, and with Israel. And he was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights, and did neither eat bread nor drink water. And he wrote upon the tables of the words of the covenant, the 10 commandments. And it came to pass, when Moses came down from Mount Sinai, that the 2 tables of the testimony in Moses' hand, when he came down from the mount, that Moses wist not that the skin of his face shone with while he talked with him. And when Aaron and all the children of Israel saw Moses, behold, the skin of his face shone, and they were afraid to come nigh him. And Moses called unto them, and Aaron and all the rulers of the congregation returned unto him, and Moses talked with them. And afterward all the children of Israel came nigh, and he gave them in commandment all that the Lord had spoken with him in Mount Sinai. Until Moses had done speaking with them, he put a veil on his face. And when Moses went in before the Lord to speak with him, he took the veil off until he came out. And he came out and spoke unto the children of Israel that which he had was commanded. And the children of Israel saw the face of Moses, that the skin of Moses' face shone. And Moses put the veil upon his face again until he went in to speak with him. And Moses gathered all the congregation of the children of Israel together, and said unto them, These are the words which the Lord hath commanded, that ye should do them. 6 days shall work be done, but on the 7th day there shall be to you an holy day, a Sabbath of rest to the Lord. Whosoever doeth work therein shall be put to death. Ye shall kindle no fire throughout your habitations upon the Sabbath day. And Moses spake unto all the congregation of the children of Israel, saying, This is the thing which the Lord commanded, saying, Take ye from among you an offering unto the Lord. Whosoever is of a willing heart, let him bring it, an offering of the Lord, gold and silver and brass, and blue and purple and scarlet, and fine linen and goats' hair, and ram's skin, dyed red, and badger skins, and shittim wood, and oil for a light, and spices for anointing oil, and for a sweet incense, and onyx stones, and stones to be set for the ephod, and for the breastplate. And every wise-hearted among you shall come, and make all that the Lord hath commanded. The tabernacle, his tent, and his covering, his stages, and his boards, his bars, his pillars, and his sockets, the ark, and the staves thereof, with the mercy seat and the veil of the covering, the table and his staves and all his vessels, and the shewbread, the candlestick also for the light, and his furniture, and his lamps with the oil for the light, and the incense altar and his staves and the anointing oil, and the sweet incense and the hanging for the door at the entering in of the tabernacle, the altar of burnt offering, with his brazen grate, his staves, and all his vessels, the laver and his foot, the hangings of the court, his pillars and their sockets, and the hanging of the door of the court, the pins of the tabernacle, and the pins of the court, and the cords, the cloth of service to do service in the holy place, the holy garments of Aaron the priest, and the garments of his sons, to minister in the priest's office. And all the congregation of the children of Israel departed from the presence of Moses. And they came, every one whose heart stirred him up, and every one whom the Spirit made willing, and they brought the Lord's offering to the work of the tabernacle of the congregation, and for all his service, and for the holy garments. And they came both men and women, as many as were willing hearted, and brought bracelets, and earrings, and rings, and tablets, and all jewels of gold. And every man that offered an offering of gold unto the Lord. And every man with whom was fault found blue, and purple, and scarlet, and fine linen, and goats' hair, and red skins of rams, and badger skins, brought them. Everyone that did offer an offering of silver and brass brought the Lord's offering. And every man with whom was found shittim wood for any work of the service brought it, and all the women that were wise hearted did spin with their hands, and brought that which they had spun, both of blue and of purple and of scarlet and of fine linen. and all the women whose hearts stirred in them up in wisdom spun goats' hair, and the rulers brought onyx stones and stones to be set for the ephod and for the breastplate, and spice and oil for the light and for the anointing oil, for sweet incense. The children of Israel brought a willing offering unto the Lord, every man and woman, whose heart made them willing to bring for all manner of work, which the Lord hath commanded to be made by the hand of Moses. And Moses said unto the children of Israel, See, the Lord hath called by name Bezaleel, the son of Uri, the son of Hur, of the tribe of Judah, and he hath filled him with the Spirit of God, in wisdom, in understanding, and in knowledge, and in all manner of workmanship, and to devise curious works, to work in gold, and in silver, and in brass, and in the cutting of stones, to set them, and in carving of wood, and to make any manner of cunning work. And he hath put in his heart that he may teach, both he and Aholiab, the son of Ahisamach, of the tribe of Dan. Them hath he filled with wisdom of heart, to work all manner of work, of the engraver, and of the cunning workman, and of the embroiderer, in blue and in purple, in scarlet and in fine linen, and of the weaver, and of them that do any work, and of those that devise cunning work. Then wrought Bezaleel and Aholiab, and every wise-hearted man, in whom the Lord put wisdom and understanding to know how to work all manner of work for the service of the sanctuary, according to all that the Lord had commanded. And Moses called Bezaleel and Aholiab, and every wise-hearted man, in whose heart the Lord hath put wisdom, even every one whose heart stirred up to come unto the work to do it. And they received of Moses all the offering which the children of Israel had brought for the work of the service of the sanctuary, to make it withal. And they brought yet up unto him free offerings of every morning. And all the wise men that wrought all the work of the sanctuary came every man from his work which they made. And they spake unto Moses, saying, The people bring much more than enough for the service of work which the Lord commanded to make. And Moses gave commandment, and they caused it to be proclaimed throughout the camp, saying, Let neither man nor woman make any more work for the offering of the sanctuary. So the people were restrained from bringing, for the stuff they had was sufficient for all the work to make it, and too much. And every wise-hearted man among them that wrought the work of the tabernacle made 10 curtains of fine twined linen, and blue and purple and scarlet, with cherubims of cunning work made he them. The length of one curtain was 28 cubits, and the breadth of one curtain 4 cubits. The curtains were all of one size. And he coupled the 5 curtains one unto another, and the 5 curtains he coupled one unto another. And he made loops of blue and of on the edge of one curtain from the selvage on the coupling. Likewise he made in the uttermost side of another curtain, in the coupling of the second, 50 loops made he in one curtain, and 50 loops made he in the edge of the curtain, which was in the coupling of the second. And the loops held one curtain to another. And he made 50 taches of gold, and coupled the curtains one unto another with the taches, so it became one tabernacle. And he made curtains of goats' hair for the tent of the tabernacle. 11 curtains he made them. The length of one curtain was 30 cubits, and 4 cubits was the breadth of one curtain. The 11 curtains were of one size. And he coupled 5 curtains by themselves, and 6 curtains by themselves. And he made 50 loops upon the uttermost edge of the curtain in the coupling. And 50 loops he made he upon the edge of the curtain, which coupleth the second. And he made 50 taches of brass to couple the tent together, that it might be one. And he made a covering for the tent of ram's skins dyed red, in a covering of badger skin above that. And he made boards of the tabernacle of shittim wood standing up. The length of the board was 10 cubits, and the breadth of it of a board 1 cubit and a half. One board and that had two tenons, equally distant from one another. Thus did he make for all the boards of the tabernacle. And he made boards of the tabernacle 20 boards of the south side southward, and 40 sockets of silver he made under the 20 boards, 2 sockets under the one board of his two tenons, and 2 sockets under another board for his two tenons. And for the other side of the tabernacle, which is toward the north corner, he made 20 boards, and there 40 sockets of silver, 2 sockets under one board, and 2 sockets under another board. For the sides of the tabernacle westward he made 6 boards. And 2 boards made he from the corners of the tabernacle on the one side, and they were coupled beneath, and coupled together at the heat thereof, to one ring. Thus did he to both of them in both the corners. And there were 8 boards, and their sockets were 16 sockets of silver, under every board 2 sockets. And he made bars of shittim wood, 5 for the boards of the one side of the tabernacle, and 5 bars for the boards of the other side of the tabernacle, and 5 bars for the boards of the tabernacle for the sides westward. And he made the middle bar to shoot through the boards from the one end to the other. And he overlaid the boards with gold, and made their rings of gold to be places for the bars, and overlaid the bars with gold. And he made a veil of blue and purple and scarlet and fine twined linen. With cherubims made he it of cunning wood. And he made thereunto 4 pillars of shittim wood, and overlaid them with gold. And their hooks were of gold, and their casts for them 4 sockets of silver. And he made an hanging of the tabernacle door of blue and purple and scarlet and fine twined linen of needlework. And the 5 pillars of it were their hooks, and he overlaid their chapiters and their fillets with gold, with their 5 sockets were of brass.